Greetings, fellow Earthlings, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are in the lovely, lovely town of Koegria. Well, at least I do find it lovely. It is my base town as well, so there's something to be said about that probably. Anyhow, we are in Koegria and the sky is overcast, as you guys can see. It is almost 11 o'clock, it just turned 11, and we are right in front of the Fighters Guild, in which we are going to go ahead and, well, we'll be looking to find some work for us so that we can get upgraded to the next level that we need to get to. So let's go ahead and talk to the trainer then. Yeah, let's get a quest from him. I am Tristus Tear Greenham. I have a relatively menial job. Okay. Hunt for giant rodents. I see. Master in residence. Location of... How did we do that? Master in residence. Where is Master in residence? Yeah, it's been a while since I did this, so I sort of forgot how I, you know, navigated these areas. Maybe the option will pop up once we come outside and talk to somebody. You there, sir? Could you point me to region? I doubt it. People? Masterham residence. I sort of forgot how to navigate to it. That's a lot of knightly orders. I don't think I actually found that many knightly orders in the game. The location of pawn shops, weaponsmiths, local temples, taverns, general, regional. Let's try regional. I doubt it's in regional, but let's try general. Yeah, master and residence right here. You'll want to go south of here, alright? I shall try going south of here then. Let us talk to somebody. Let us talk to this bloke here. Let's ask him where he thinks the master of the residence is. Oh, thank you so much. This guy was kind of marked on the map for us. And we need to head just north. Slightly towards the east, actually. I think this here would be the master of the residence. Just clicking on it to confirm. Yes, it is. Alright, we get off our high horse and we will try and figure out a way into this damn place. Now I'm gonna take this opportunity since everything of mine is upgraded. I'm just gonna take... Oh yeah, I actually even got this Daedric Veil. And well, I basically bought it, turned in my Orcish Veil in exchange for this. So I'll just go ahead and level up my... hand to hand. Why can I not climb any higher? Am I stuck somewhere? I feel like I am? Okay, I was standing on a giant bat. That's why. And yeah, you just essentially roam around and let them spawn in. That's literally all that this quest is. Let them spawn in. Let them come to you. I mean, sometimes I do like the pacing of these quests, especially when compared to, you know, the more intensely paced ones, such as the Nightly Order quests and Medora's Freedom. Stuff like that is, ooh, that's difficult. Who are you? And why do you look like Prince Elsith? This guy is durable. I think I'm missing half my shots. Yeah. So, excuse me about that. So, I wonder who this fellow is. He reminds me a lot of Prince Elsa, to be honest. beats the Viking, from the looks of it. Oh, hi there. Really? It takes a lot of hits to kill them, doesn't it? Like, my hand-to-hand sucks. I wonder why, even though my strength is pretty high, I do believe. But my hand-to-hand still sucks. It still does suck. At least I can get my shots off quicker now. So that's something to be happy about, I suppose. I hear more of these things. And for a change, I find a different module here. Okay, somebody spawned down here. Yeah. I actually did not realize the kickboxing was a thing back then. No, please open up. Kicking the door open like that is, it's a different kind of pleasure. Like, the knockback on these guys is quite significant. But for whatever reason, I don't think there's a way up there from here. Not from here, at least. We've already visited that area. And we checked in there as well. You can hear more of them. So, they're either... Yeah, there's no way to access them from here. Is one of them here? No, there's no one here. So I suppose the only way to really... Yeah, there's one up there. Okay, I hit something here. I'll try loitering here for an hour. I'll try loitering here for another hour. Okay, cool. That means that I have completed this quest and we are free to leave. Alright, back to the fighter's guild. That felt sort of strange, standing there like that. Where was it again? I think it was due north, actually, yeah. It's actually been a while since I touched this game, and I feel like that's the case every single time that I touch this game anyway. That has always really been a while since I have last touched this game. I don't want to grab this guy, so let's talk to him. Killing bats even giant ones doesn't take much skill, but it pays the same, eh? I suppose it does. I should have saved the previous time around, but I did not, so let me just go ahead and save this time before I take a quest. Every once in a while, we get an idiot like this client. Some fool left his back door open and a wild animal got in. He seems rather confused as to whether it is a bear or a tiger, but in either case, it wanted to eat him. We need you to go and slay the animal. Your standard fee is 616 gold. Want to take it, Grimfangs? Sure. Great, go over to Superior General Store in Van Castle Garden. I'll give you 9 days to kill it and get back to me. Van Castle Garden, Superior General Store. And Koegria, Van Castle Garden. No, ships don't travel on the land. You know what? It's a good thing that it says I'm healthy, but the fast travel menu says otherwise. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a potion of I probably have the plague. I've probably contracted the plague from those guys. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a potion of cure disease. No, not cure poison. Cure poison, cure disease, right here. Cool. So now we are free to travel to Van Castle Garden. And we head there on our horse. It'll take one day. Hand to hand is improved, which is what I wanted to see anyway. But I'll keep improving it even further. Although, let me just go ahead and check out my... Yeah, it's not in my minor skills, it's in my... Yeah, hand to hand is 37%. Hand to hand damage is 48%. sorry, 4 to 8. So that's not a lot of damage, to be honest. Not a lot of damage. You know what? Let me just go ahead and increase my. Short blade as well. I wonder why I got off my horse. So we want to go to the superior general store. General stores. The superior general store. Just go south. Right. It's a bit of a walk, but not that big of a ride, I suppose. So at least I'm hoping. That's just a residence. That also seems to be a residence. Yes, it is. Now, typically in Daggerfall, when you click on something, it knows what you're clicking on. You just need to, like. That might just be the superior general store that we're looking for. It is a general store. Look, first class trading post. Is this the superior general store? Yes, yes, it is. Alright, time to pull out our short sword. Oh, it's a saber-toothed tiger. Well, that was anticlimactic. I suppose I'll just go ahead and browse his wares then. Not that I'm expecting to find anything of value in here. Just in the hopes that I might find something of value. And the thing about this game is only in. Oh, really? He's got a Daedric short sword? Wow. Did not expect that. Well, I guess you can find things of value. And a Daedric axe at that. Damn. I mean, this guy's two entire Daedric products. I mean, wow. If only he had some Daedric armor for me. Yeah. So anyway, that was our mission here. So let us, yeah, I'm just gonna go back on foot this time around. Back to Koegria. Let's see if it still takes the same amount of time one day. I suppose as long as you have a horse in your inventory, it just it decreases the travel time for you. Oh, I like this theme. But I do believe it's early morning when I arrived, so I'll have to wait in front of the fighter's guild for some time. He gave me 9 days to complete this, I did it in 2. So I've heard that houses with pigs in front of them, they're supposed to be thieves' guilds. It just says residence on the map, to be honest. But anyway, I'll get to know more in my thief playthrough. Which I'm looking forward to. But first I'm gonna do like a horse playthrough. Why did I click on horse again? And what's funny to me is the fact that there's a ship here. So I wonder if I like buy a ship, if I can manage to buy a ship. Do I get to like sail on the water or use it on land? I wonder how it works. So what's the time right now? 6:22, that is 5 hours of waiting, 3 hours at a time. Now 2 hours. I really like this song. I really like this piece of music. Oh hi there, were you waiting with me? Interesting. Yeah, F4. I tend to forget what all of these keys do. Yeah, let's talk to him. No great difficulties, I trust? Thought not. Here's your 616 gold. Thank you so much. Now, I suppose I'll save here again. Something's come up. I don't know what who else could handle it but you, Grimfangs. This is bad critter in the haunt of Balthanon, Daedroth. Oh my god. Now, I ain't lying. No one knows why it's there, but everyone wants it gone. For 753 gold. You think you could handle it, Grimfangs? Alright, I guess. I mean, hey, alright, your funeral, Grimfangs. Listen, knock off that Daedroth and get back here in 10 days for your reward. I don't know how long that thing's gonna be around, so you're gonna wanna move your ass. And listen to me on this, Grimfangs. Go prepared for a hell of a fight. Now, I've taken on Daedroths, if that is what this guy's referring to right now. The same music. Lovely. Ah, yes. Haunt of Dalthanon. For role-playing purposes. Haunt of Dalthanon. At least it doesn't roll. Yeah, for toss. But I would like to put this back into the wagon, and I would like to equip this thing here. Alright, we're good. Let's go. Now I can see the first challenge already, and that is crossing over into the side. As you can see, my movement speed has decreased. Alright, time to save in front of the dungeon, and here's to hoping that this dungeon is kind to us. Now we're here looking for a Daedroth. Oh, it's this dungeon, okay. So, should we go up there first, or should we... Yeah, let's check down here first. Since it's on the way. Any hidden doors thus far? I do not think so. I just hope that the rest of the enemies in this dungeon aren't stronger than the Daedroth himself, so... Wish me luck. Oh, damn. Okay, they're vampires. I just hope there are no vampire ancients in this level. That would suck. That would actually suck. Okay, there are two chambers here. I hear another vampire somewhere. Unless I missed seeing it when I first saw this one. Okay, none here. This seems to be one of the smaller dungeons. So I'm hoping that I can find the Daedroth pretty easily, like comparatively easily at least. I wouldn't have to explore too much for it. Okay, so that was that for that module. I mean, that was a pretty small module. But although I could hear vampires here and there. So that's something else that we have wondered about as well, as to why I could hear vampires there. Did we explore all of it? Like, did we miss any hidden doors or anything of that nature? I'd not think so. Like, we went around it and that was all there was to that side. And then we came up and that was all there was to this side. So I guess right now... Oh, that's the vampire that's making all those all that noise. Although, I wonder how that vampire is so fast. That's a rat. I wonder what a rat is doing here, of all places. I think there was supposed to be, yeah, there was supposed to be a door here. That's what I was wondering, why isn't there like a door here? More loot. 120 gold pieces and some flowers. Okay, let's use a potion of resist shock and a potion... Now what should we use? I don't think we can use much against this guy. Just that I would like to use my silent tights. Okay. So I hope this guy has been silenced. Yeah, he didn't cast any spells, so I assume he has been silenced, otherwise he would have hit us with like a triple shock spell right off the bat. So vampire ancients are the one thing that still give me trouble in this game. I'll just go ahead and save here since we have made some progress. This section is pretty linear. This dungeon actually is pretty linear. Not a lot of roaming around here and there. Like, pretty straightforward path. For the most part. Like, It has like a few different modules here and there. Like this module here. This module was absent in the previous dungeon that I'd been to. The previous few dungeons that I'd been to in Koegria. It's like all the dungeons in the region follow a certain formula. That brings me out at a similar looking place elsewhere. Except this place only has one path to go. I hear a vampire. Okay, this seems different. I just hope there are no teleporters here. Lots of vampires. You know what would really suck? If there's a trapdoor down there that I need to open. That would suck. I hear more vampires and I'm pretty sure that they're all down there. What I do not want to hear right now is a vampire ancient. Because that would suck. Chameleon form. Oh yeah, that reminds me. I've got like a boatload of potions in my wagon that I have to put into my character's inventory. That I keep forgetting to put into my character's inventory. Typically, this dungeon module is associated with a trapdoor that you need to open. So I just hope that that is not the case here. And what I'm surprised about is the fact that I can pick up all this loot. Now, making another save in lieu of all this loot. Excuse me, my pronunciation isn't the clearest today. This one shocked me. I wasn't expecting to see you like that. Let me take those 15 gold pieces for whatever matters. Actually, I am healed, so I'll just go ahead and update the save again. It's quite surprising that I haven't lost the tiniest fraction of health yet. Well, one good thing that I see as far as this module was concerned is that I was wondering why I am able to carry so much loot. Anyway, more loot. 45 gold pieces. Right, so this area was a dead end. Good thing that we came and cleared it out anyway. I will just make a cursory check to see if there's anything else remaining in this section here. Don't think there is like a hidden door of sorts. Yeah, there isn't any hidden door or anything. Alright, back up we go. I wonder if there's a hidden door here. I doubt it. Yeah, there isn't. Let's go back up. I can hear more of those vampires there. Which leads me to believe that there might actually be some more vampires left there. But no. There's nothing there to be honest. This is all done and dusted. So, despite the differences in modules, this dungeon seems pretty straightforward. Not that, complicated. Does not mean that it is an easy module, easy dungeon by any means, but it's just not as complicated at all. Ultimately, we will find a way down there as well, but here's hoping that we find the Daydrot before we ever get down there. Now, this thing there, that lever, it just controls that bridge. So there's no need to click on that lever. We'll be going here first. Okay. I wonder what this is. And I wonder what it did. I hope it did not... Yeah, it did not move this bridge, so... It did something, I just don't know what it did. But it for sure did something. It triggered something. I really don't know what it triggered though. But I suppose flipping it... Okay. I see. I'm just gonna save in the emergency slot here, although I'm pretty sure that we cannot actually go through this. despite our best efforts, but... So it's that module. It is that module. Hello there, vampire. I doubt I can pick up any ghouls you have, but I will try nonetheless. So let me just go ahead and try clearing this side off. If my memory serves me right, this way should be a shorter... This way should not have much, to be honest. Yeah, just a resting room. We're looking for a Daedroth, and I hope it's one of those green, frog-looking things. I sometimes wonder what this lever does. Right now, I'm not gonna hit it though. I'm gonna go down here first, because from what I recall, this is more or less a dead end as well. Doesn't have much behind it. $840 gold, I can certainly carry that much gold again. Let me just go and update my save. Since it has been a while since I saved. Hi there, two of you guys. Come here, please. Okay, I need to use a potion of resist shock and a potion of free action. And I'll need to use my silent tights. So this guy accidentally killed his own ally in his process to try and kill me. I'm just gonna rest until I'm fully healed. That was a tough encounter. Three enemies. Backstabbing and blunt weapon have improved, which is amazing. Which is good, which is great. What is this? Map. Maybe I can equip this. I'm not gonna try and pronounce that. Grabbing all of these corpses sort of feels wrong. But I'm just gonna try doing that anyway. That's just a rat. So thus far this dungeon isn't going that bad. And just when I said that, we are greeted by this guy. Who is a literal walking nightmare. Really? I'm silenced? Okay. Reaction, right here. Vampire Ancient died. I doubt you have anything that I can get from you. Unless it's like, you know, Daedric boots or pauldrons or anything, but yeah. Just saving in the new slot for the heck of it. Oh, so that's what that lever opens, I assume. I'm assuming here, but I assume that is what the lever opens. That lever, although that path itself is all another can of worms, to be honest. They both lead to the same module, but it's like another can of worms altogether. Yeah, now we have two paths to choose from. And I hear a vampire ancient. I wonder what that... Okay, so this is a dead end, which is a good thing. Because typically that leads somewhere. That should be one of the ways upstairs. Oh, there are spiders here. Okay. Well, that spider is also dead. That is good. Is there a spider behind me? Of course there is. The spider died. No, they could be the Daedroth could be somewhere down there, but yeah, you know what, let's just check down there before we come here. Let's just go ahead and check down there before we come here. Was this the way down, I wonder? Yes it was. Okay, we need to use a potion of resist shock. I hope we have a potion of resist shock. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Yeah, I'm gonna use it from the inventory here. Yeah, I don't think that guy... I'm gonna take this and keep it in my inventory. I can't carry any more stuff. That went well, comparatively. As well as it could have been gone, at least. While my potion of resist shock is still active, let me just go ahead and try and get rid of as many of these guys as possible. I won't get the same chance again. Wow. This guy took a lot of hits. Two of them here. Come here, while my spell is still active. Come on. I ain't got all day. Alright. Until fully healed. So, since I can rest here, it sort of tells me that... there are no enemies nearby. So, yeah, let's keep this potion as well. It's a useful potion. So, this leads us to the main area and... okay, just a couple of vampires. Nothing, not too big of a deal, to be honest. They're just taking a while to die is all. And yeah. And this is pretty much it. This is all there is to this, you know, little section here. Oh no. Oh no. Did I save recently? Yes, I did. Alright. Should be another one right here. Oh no. Oh no. Why? Why? Oh wait, I can probably use the jade here. And can you die, please? Okay, and I'm gonna use a, you know, I'm gonna use all of those as well, but what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna, wait, I did not get that mark identified, that's strange. Anyway, I'm just gonna use a potion of heal through. Alright, so... there's a little bit of randomization in the enemy generation, apparently. And nobody's behind me? Good. I'm gonna try climbing up again. And hopefully this time I don't fall down. Into the void. Good. That's how things should be. That is how things should be. Let me just go ahead and... oh wait, I'm on the other side. Let me just go ahead and clear out this path here as well. If there is at all a path here. Does not seem to be the case. So, at this point, I feel like I'm running out of potions of resist shock. I'll need to play this game a little more cautiously from here on out. Yeah, nothing here. I can hit a vampire here. As is appropriate, there should be a vampire here. You know what I'll be pissed about if I clear this entire area and the data drop is nowhere to be found in here. But yeah, at least it's a dungeon crawl, so there's that. I was certain that I would probably like get a promotion this time around, but apparently not. But typically I'm supposed to take a left here to, you know... actually, I think I'm supposed to take a right at this juncture, but... like, that was the case with Metora's freedom. Like, as long as it's just a vampire, I'm cool with you, but what I'm not cool with is a vampire ancient. Fuck those guys. Anyway, let's carry on with our exploration. One of these paths is going to lead us to a place that we've already been to. So I wonder where that other path takes us then. That wasn't a particularly long path at all, to be honest. So we come all the way down here, and then we take this right, and we take this left. I hear some very objectionable content in there, being the reason why I do not want to open this door, but if it must be, so be it. Hold up, let me just save the emergency slot here. I'm getting a bad vibe about this. Okay, this room is clear. I wonder why it was locked in the first place. 90 gold? Hey, I could finally pick up some loot. I also hear like a spider, no wonder. I was wondering why I could hear a spider. Hi there. I hear something snarling. Although I'm pretty sure that's not what I'm looking for in this dungeon. There are enemies nearby. I'll just update the save here. And where do we go next? Let's take this road on the left. Oh, sorry, not that. Yeah. Here. It's like every single time that I open this game up again, I need to make an effort to familiarize myself with the game. This section is usually pointless. I suppose that area also has a rat in it. Yes, it does. Did you see that thing trying to bite me? I wonder if you can bite through tremor armor, little rat. Little hat. And there are two bots that we can go through. Let me just drop this here. Two further bots. Let's take the one on the right then. I thought for a second that this was actually a dead end, but no, it's just angled poorly. Okay, there's a door to my left, but I feel like I've already... Yes, I have. I have successfully been there. Been there, done that. I went upstairs as well. And that took me to yet another place, which I left half explored, I do believe. No, actually, I did explore it completely. The place upstairs, though, is still left half explored. I would like to see what's behind door number 2 here, before proceeding further. But first, time to rest. Oh shit! Where's the damn thing? Silentites. Damn. Load saved game. Which was the last saved game? was this it? I do not recall. I don't think I made a save as recent as that, to be honest. I think this is the most recent save that we have. Just goes to show you the importance of saving in this game at regular intervals. I'm healed this time around. I did not have to face that violent creature that calls itself the Walker of the Night. And yeah, you'll take this left here because that is the path we took the last time around as well. And we'll just completely mark this map off. I mean, when you bump into that wall, it sort of looks like a dead end all of a sudden, doesn't it? So, since we marked this place off, let us go ahead and update this here save. And hopefully there won't be a vampire ancient coming for our hides this time around. But just a vampire. Right then. Now, typically, when I've been in these, dungeons, in this particular dungeon, or this style of dungeon, I've not really explored it as much, because my quest objectives were to find and kill a particular type of enemy, and not, you know, so we should probably be going right. So, and not even find and kill the enemies, will just seek you out. We have to kill X number of a certain enemy, and okay, you sort of jump scared me there. And yeah, those enemies just come to you. You don't really need to go looking for them, unlike this case here, wherein the enemies don't actually come to you voluntarily. You have to insert yourself into the equation and essentially just go hunting. There's no other way about it. Alright, so that's that. So I suppose we head back downstairs. I think we have completely explored this little area here. So let us head back downstairs, and if we see a vampire ancient, we're not going to be engaging. We're going to run straight past it. We essentially need to head towards that door there. And go back out and head this way now. I hear what I think is a saber-toothed tiger, but I cannot be certain. Overwriting the save again. That goes somewhere downstairs, that goes somewhere upstairs. And there's a path right in front of me, so where should I go? I mean, this game is full of dilemmas, you know? Full of dilemmas. Since I'm exploring this side first, might as well mark it on the map. Okay. Resist shock. Do we have a resist shock? I would like a resist shock. But do we have a resist? We do have a resist shock. Yeah, we don't really have anything else that we can use, except for this thing here. I don't know whether it was successful, but I think this guy is actually using his shock spell. He's just unable to hit us because we have popped in a potion of resist shock, which is excellent. Which is as things should be. You know, previously I'd never really explored this, these kinds of dungeons a lot, and I had always thought that, oh, you know what, these are tiny dungeons, not really worth a lot of exploration points, but my god, are these things insanely large. So this is where we come out, and which I suppose is a good sign. We'll head down there, but first let me check what's behind this door here. I think there's a rat. Yes, the rats are in my opinion the most detailed creatures in this game, but there are other parts here that we are yet to explore, so we will get back to it. Exploring those other parts, I mean. And I think we took a detour in here, so yeah, let's go downstairs and explore. This will probably take us down a level. Oh yeah, it's the underwater section, which I'm not really eager to explore, to be honest. Did not think that a fighter skill quest would prove to be quite as difficult, to be honest. I thought fighter skill quest would be easier. Just goes to show how this game can sometimes mess with your expectations. Again, expectations that were set by the game itself, but yeah. You get the point, right? Saving again. Time to start spamming quick saves. I see a spider up ahead, but no Daedroth yet. Spider is dead. No, it went over the Daedra that we did. Okay, so this is where we have come out. Right then, so there was another part to this level here that we had not explored. Sorry, not this door. Not this one either. That's where the vampire engine came out of. Oh wait, we actually went there. Didn't we? So I suppose we have completely explored most parts of this dungeon then. Except for this here hidden door which we seemingly missed. So I suppose we go upstairs then and get to that hidden door. Although I doubt that Daedroth will be behind it. Then again, I don't think I've ever heard the kind of sounds that Daedroth makes. So it's apparently to my left here. Somewhere here? No, it's behind me. Okay. ₹90 gold pieces, and of course I cannot carry the flower. I'll save this here. Yeah, I'll beckon you to wait for a bit. Potion of restore power, completely useless to me. Thank you for trying, but those kinds of spells don't hurt me a bit. Ooh, this would bludgeon somebody. Too bad it's a two-handed thing. I don't really use those. Oh, there's the Daedroth! The Daedroth is dead. Okay, thank you. Thank you for dying. Okay, time for me to extract out of this dungeon. I'm playing a little too much Delta Force 2. Time to get out. And we do that by... Well, the shortcut is through here. We go all the way to the top and just... take this path. Run along this entire route and we're golden. Pretty sure we're not going to be finding any more of these critters here to bother us. I can run fast as well now. I'm hoping that I do get a promotion after this. No, I wanna get out. Thank you. Okay, I'll just let the horse do the grunt work. And back to Koegria it is. Of all the places to find the damn thing, we found it there. In the middle of nowhere. It's sad that as my level has been going up, I can carry less and less amounts of gold just because I'm carrying more amounts of other things on my person. How is my health? I'm healthy. At least I don't have vampirism. Which I would consider myself super lucky, the fact that I haven't caught vampirism yet. Wait. This is where I go, right? Yes. Yes it is. I did not realize the bank was... there was a bank right here. Let me just go ahead and mark them on the map. Bank of Koegria. There are three banks of Koegria apparently. At least three branches to the bank. Three banks of Koegria. That would be silly. Thieves Guild. Well, not that my warrior is supposed to know that, but I wonder if that's no. That's a kitten. What time is it right now? Oh. Yeah, I can like literally just go walk right in. Okay. Let's go talk to you then. Hey, you're a better nod than me, Grimfangs. Daedroth killer. I like it. Here's a gold. I wonder if I can actually carry all that gold. Maybe I'll have to keep something into my wagon. But this guy's not an odd, he looks like a red guard. Anyhow. Yeah, thought as much. Time to pull out the wagon then. Let's keep the blood in the wagon, maybe that way we can take... Of course we can't. Of course we still cannot do that. Letter of credit, I'll keep this on my person. Water walking. Yeah, I don't think there's anything here that's too heavy. 2.5 kilograms, 0.25 kilograms. I don't have a lot of stuff that I can put into the wagon either, to be honest. So what can I put away? What can I possibly put away then? So I suppose I can put away like... Yeah, I can probably put away either this or the open tunic of paralysis. So I guess I'll put away these boots here. Yeah, I wanna take these back and put them into my wagon, not into his hands. It's not an exchange. I'm getting a reward at this point. Undeniable access, I cannot put that into the wagon, even though I hardly use it. Unrestrainable tall boots. Notorco also, I suppose I could keep these in the wagon itself. Let's just keep everything in the wagon first and then we decide what to wear and what not to wear. Cast one helps, water walking, long shot of the wise. Well, unrestrainable tall boots. But this round shield of toxic clouds. This is interesting, but I don't see myself using it that often, to be honest. Cure poison. I think I had other things that cured my poison as well when I'm antidote. This is 0.25 kilograms. This is also 0.25 kilograms. This is also 0.25 kilograms. So I suppose I can keep this and, well, this into the wagon as well. Mark, I have no idea what this mark does. Jade protector, that is useful. Ruby of Shocking is also useful. Now, what else can we put in there? I suppose I can put the shield in there as well. That should free up enough space to where we can carry our reward. Now, let me just pull out my wagon and get all the potions that I've stashed in there. There should be quite a few. Yeah, that's nice. Alright then, let me just go ahead and save here. Let's see what else he has in store for us. I hope it won't be a series of 5 quests. Of course not. They're better than that. Congratulations, Grimfangs. Because of your outstanding weaponry prowess, we've promoted you to the rank of Guardian in the guild. Among other benefits, this increase means cheaper weapon repair and more profitable work assignments. Now, weapon repair is good and all, but we can't repair magical items in this game, which is... well, the entire game in and of itself. But at least we got to end on a dungeon crawling. Unnoted dungeon crawling, so we'll consider that as a positive, to be honest. Because, well, we didn't get to crawl a lot of dungeons in, when we're doing the Fighter's Guild questlines. And the fact of the matter is, despite all the plots and everything in this game, at its heart, it is a dungeon crawler. It just has other additional requirements built on top of the crawling aspect. So yeah, as for why is she walking towards me? You better stop there. Good, thank you. So yeah, as for today's video, that was that. We were at the rank of water and we were planning on going up one rank into the rank of Guardian. So, we have already acquired the rank of Paladin. Our ultimate goal here is to be the Master of the Fighter's Guild. So, yeah, we'll be pursuing that goal. But until then, we will also be pursuing other, you know, main quest objectives. This is essentially a side quest that we are doing right now. I'm just having fun mixing all of the quests in between. We were waiting for a vision from Medora and we got that vision as well, so that leaves me wondering whether or not I should do a listener's betrayal right now, or maybe we should go ahead and pursue that vision instead. I think I'll pursue the vision first, because there's like a period after that vision wherein, you know, we must wait until the next lead arrives. So I suppose I'll just mix in a listener's betrayal into that during that, you know, waiting period as well, while I try and get sometime maybe before or after I try and get the next promotion in rank at the Fighter's Guild here. And of course, after we get betrayed by Elysana, we cannot go into the Knights of the Rose anymore. Not that we need to, since we're already a paladin there. Because if we go there, we might just get demoted, you know, because of our drop in reputation with them. Anyhow, this was it for today's video. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be covering... well, I think it was... the quest is called Dust of Restful Death, if I'm not wrong. I think that's what it's called. So yeah, when we come back, we'll be covering Dust of Restful Death. I'm just gonna call it that for now, where we actually fetch the ash from Godfog. Yeah, Metro came to me in a vision and told me that Lysander's... there should be another, you know, apostrophe S here. Ghost could be soothed if I convince... if I can convince Godfog, Lord of the Orcs, and Obsidian to tell me where it is. Okay... I want Godfog to tell me where a certain death... sorry, where a certain dust is. That's strange. No, not where a certain dust is. I thought it was about finding dust. Turns out it's about finding the ghost. So maybe that's just the, how this quest gets logged. Anyhow, we're getting ahead of ourselves here. So that's essentially the concern for tomorrow's video. For today, this is it. Until next time, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.